Nice to meet you.
I'm Dennis Kucinich.
Hi, I'm your co-host.
Hi, I'm Dina Boyer. I produce Tranny.
Nice to see you. Hi.
Greg, my first.
How are you doing?
Hi.
I'm Robin.
Nice to see you. Okay.
I'm Joe.
Nice to see you.
Hello.
Hi, I'm Michelle.
Thank you.
Nice to see you.
How are you?
Good to see you.
You're going to be sitting here next to me.
Okay.
Thank you very much for coming on Tranny.
Oh, that is.
Are we rolling?
Yes, we're rolling.
You are a man who wants to be president. Your name is Dennis Kucinich.
Right.
And you were born in 1946. And in your lifetime, you've been homeless, is what I read on your website.
Right.
So how long were you homeless? And what did you learn from being homeless?
Well, I was 11, 12 years old. And my family was homeless a few months at a time with their car. Family grew from one child to seven, never owned a home, and as we moved, the growth of the family became tougher to find a place to rent. So that plus illness, and it became difficult sometimes to find a place when you needed it.
So what could you do for the homeless, as we all know that the numbers are growing annually in San Francisco and across the nation in general? What do you think that you could do to help the homeless situation in this country?
Well, I've actually been very involved with homeless issues. In the city of Cleveland, I helped to bring together summits for homeless people to talk about their concerns. We worked to establish a homeless shelter in Cleveland. We worked to make sure that the homeless get mental health assistance. But nationally, there's a greater cause here. That cause has to be to build affordable housing, to make it possible for people to be able to get vouchers if they need to for rental purposes, to make sure that people can buy a home. And sometimes it's going to mean people having access to jobs, a living wage, universal health care. We need to make sure that we do something about the maldistribution of wealth. You know, one of the problems in society is as the wealth is increasingly distributed upwards, it means that there are less opportunities for people. We're finding an increase in poverty. So we have to attack the whole arc of poverty issues.
Okay.
And that's what I intend to do. And in addition to that, we need more shelters. We need to deal with the mental illness problems, which put many homeless. We need to make sure that our veterans have opportunities for housing. A lot of the homeless are veterans. Many of the homeless are people who are mentally ill.
Oh, and trust me, and there's a lot of transsexuals that are homeless. And I think of one of the ways to be able to not be homeless maybe is to join the military. But because of the lesbian and gay and bisexual transgender people in general, because right now there's a big push for lesbian and gay and bisexual people, and you support them being able to openly serve in the military, which is, I think, is a wonderful thing. But since you support the LGBT community, why do you think that a lot of the presidential candidates really never touch this subject, or really just never talk about it, besides maybe Bill Clinton, who actually stepped up to the podium and said, "I embrace you all"? Why do you think the presidents are so afraid of our community?
I think that the LGBT community really provides a challenge to people's own sense of who they are. And unless you're really sure of who you are, unless you're really sure of your commitment to your inner truth, there may be a difficulty in acceding that to others. And so we need to have a society that's whole. And it starts with leaders who strive to be whole. Well, we have to work on ourselves. And as we do that, we can help the work of the nation. So it's about not judging oneself. It's about compassion. It's about seeing the other person as an aspect of oneself. And when you do that, everyone's included. No one's excluded.
So what would you say to the people that are sitting in the Midwest that are saying, why should we let a lesbian, gay, or bisexual? Especially, I know a lot of transsexuals, such as myself when I was younger, because I've been a transsexual since the age of 13. I would have loved to have been able to join the military and been able to fight for my country, because I am a true American, and I believe in strongly that I'm a religious American. Even though I'm transsexual, you know, I still say that I'm very religious and I am an American, and I would have fought for this country. So what would you say to those people in the Midwest that are saying, why should we allow the lesbian and gay and bisexual transgender community to serve in the military? Why? What?
This country belongs to everyone, and everyone, there has to be a place in America for everyone who wants to serve.
Did you think that there's ever a possibility that that our community will be able to serve?
Well, already we know that that there are people from the community who do serve.
Not openly, though.
But the question is whether people should be permitted to serve this country and be who they are. And I think that should be possible. You know, this is America. The American dream is that people should have the opportunity to not just be who they are, but to be able to celebrate who they are. Not to have to nullify their existence. And so we need an America that is tolerant, that is non-judgmental, that celebrates diversity, that's not afraid of differences, that connects heart to heart with people, and never worry about about the aspects of self that sometimes separate people, but to move for a more inclusive connection that we have through the human heart. And that's what we're all one. That's what we ought to be focusing on.
Okay, I have one last two-part question, sure. Since I know that your schedule is very busy. Legalizing marijuana has become a very big issue in the state of California, especially San Francisco, in the Canada, with medical purposes. And then also legalizing prostitution has been a big talk in this city and across the nation about legalizing prostitution, because maybe if we started taxing the prostitutes, our country would not be in so much of a deficit. At least that's what I strongly personally believe. What is your stance on legalizing the marijuana for cannabis uses and prostitution?
Yeah, you know, I would say that on the legalization of marijuana issue, I'm not in favor of having the Justice Department busy prosecuting those individuals who are users of marijuana. I don't think it's a wise use of the talents in our Justice Department. The issue of prostitution is a little bit more complex because what we need to do, I think, is to make sure that we have a system that protects public health. I really see it as a public health issue, not so much as an issue that ought to be riveted on questions of morality, because we know that some of the most moral people have, as we've read in newspaper accounts, sought the services
of
men or women outside their marriage. So we understand that. So we need to move away from the judgment and get to the public health issues. We need to understand that that people who are prostitutes should have the opportunity for a full range of health services, so that their own health is protected, and so they're not transmitting diseases. That's where I'd put the focus. I wouldn't put the focus on punishment. We need to have an America which makes a transition away from issues where we worry about incarcerating people to where we go to rehabilitate people. Give people a chance to participate in society at large and not be in a position where everything is condemnation.
I do this with all my big politicians, so what I'd like to have you do, last statement, is look at my camera and tell me, when it comes down to voting for President of the United States, why should I vote for you, being a transsexual person in the community? Why should I vote for you?
First of all, thank you for...
Thank you very much for coming on Tranny Talk. I appreciate it so much.
America needs a president who's willing to reach out to all people and who sees the way in which we're all interconnected and interdependent, and that each of us has a journey which reflects our own difficulties and our own potential, our own courage. And we need to link up with each other in defense of the rights of all of us, that each person in this society should be valued, and each person has value, that each one of us needs to be recognized for the great gift we are to society and to humanity, and be given a chance to have that gift unfold, to have the opportunity to explore the truth of who we are, to not ever be forced to separate ourselves from the rest of humanity or from our brothers and sisters. I intend to be a president who will reach out and celebrate the diversity of America, celebrate the beauty of America, celebrate the joy of America, and to reconnect with that old optimism which characterize an America with a can-do attitude so that everyone can be who they are and can be what they want to be.
Thank you very much. And with the names of Willie Nelson,